Good morning, folks. I'm going to try to see if I can bring into the camera view some terrapin. And that can be a little tricky, but let's see what we can do. Takes a little time to find them, and then they don't move real fast, so that helps. Here we go. This is a female diamondback terrapin, likely preparing to come ashore to lay her eggs. When they come ashore to lay eggs, they dig a hole about 6 inches deep with their hind legs, which are well adapted for that purpose, and they'll place an average of 10 eggs in that hole. Cover it back up, and they spend a great deal of time disguising the nest to the point where you would not, even if you knew the general area where the eggs were laid, you would not be able to find it. But the skunks and raccoon can find the eggs by scent and will typically dig up half of the nests that are laid here and eat them, eat the eggs. They typically, they will nest or lay their eggs, go up and lay their eggs for most of June. Excuse me. What we're looking at is the area of our boat ramp, which they use as their access point. Makes it easy for them to come up, come ashore. That. You can see three heads of turtles sitting over there by that old ship. estimate that there's at least 100 females here that come ashore every year. And if there's 100 females, each female lays eggs twice, once around the new moon, once around the full moon in June. And if each of those 100 lay two nests of an average of 10 eggs, that would be 2,000 eggs. So quite a scale. Lots and lots of eggs. In the background, they could scare off our turtles. It's not easy to find the turtles. They really, they're shy. Really, they'll be out in more in larger numbers when the tide comes further in. They like to wait until high tide to lay their eggs. Presumably because that way their eggs will be above the tide line and safe from high water. Mostly you see their heads popping out. reflections of the grasses in the waters can be absolutely beautiful. Look at the grasses as they bend and sway with the ripples. It's just really can be beautiful. It challenges the camera though, because there is so much change going on. Osprey watching us. Oh, there's an osprey up on that pole also. Should pull that up. The osprey enjoy perching over the river and watching for fish, I suppose. See that the father martin is taking care, sitting on the babies. Let me get both of these osprey in this picture at the same time, and then I'll bring you back to that. Comes mom, she probably has some food. We'll feed the little babies, which grow so quickly. I suppose mid-July they'll be finishing up full grown. Look at this view of the osprey. One on the perch at the nest, the other out on a tall cedar pole mounted above our bar. It's a beautiful sight. peaceful morning. Another osprey nest. Look at the size of that. And they built that nest all in the matter of several weeks this year. That wasn't there. We call that the dead tree nest. Quite the builders those osprey are. Osprey certainly has plenty to say. It's sitting right next to the microphone too, so that explains the loudness. I'll turn that down a bit. catch a glimpse of the baby martins, but must be nap time. What a view. Here's our website, by the way. I'd recommend trying to watch the cameras there because it gives you excellent control and the ability to switch between cameras and watch multiple cameras. Lots of links of interesting videos. We have over 1,200 videos that you can watch. You could search them. For instance, if you were interested in heron, you could type in heron and do a search and you'd see some very, very fun videos. Sorry about that. A little noisy, huh? That is an interesting video showing a great blue heron with a rail. Oh, the rail fell flew away, but. Yes, the great blue herons are resident here year-round. I read recently that they eat rats. I've seen them eat plenty of fish, but I've never seen them eat a rat. This is a heron shaking off. Fish. These are terrapin across the river. On the mud. Don't see that very often. There's some with a hair and color. Look at this. These are all videos from the past. Here's an example of lots of terrapin in the boat ramp. Here's osprey. This is several years ago, I believe. I got all those terrapin. They bask. They love to bask, and they're laying all over each other. The osprey. Here's a speeded up version of the turtles. They need a little speeding up sometimes. Pretty slow. Osprey again. This shows the chat feature on the website. There's a group there that collaborates and shares ideas and thoughts. So many turtles here. They're safe here. It's not like along the barrier islands where there's so many people. It's a safe place for them. They don't get hit by cars. There's no traffic. They do occasionally get injured or killed by passing boats, and sometimes by getting caught in crab traps. Here's an example of a terrapin going up. You can see the muddy bottom. It's a very muddy river. Bottom is. There's our osprey. I think this is the female, but she's not having eggs this year, not raising a family, just waiting out the summer. It hasn't even started. Show you an example of some of the sunsets we see here. There's just a wide open view of the sunsets, and it reflects into the river. It's so peaceful, so beautiful. I don't know if I'm sure there's beautiful places for sunsets, but this is definitely one of the most beautiful. great boat watching here on the river. We're located only about 3 miles from the Delaware Bay, where the river meets the Delaware Bay is called East Point, where there is an old, you know, lighthouse, a red brick building, I believe, looking out over the bay, marking the opening, the access to the river. And from East Point, then, it would be about 20 miles to the Atlantic Ocean at Cape May. And at Cape May, you could turn in into the canal for safety or for passage into the intercoastal waterway to head north. Or you can go around the Cape and head north into the Atlantic Ocean, or south, where you could go across to Lewis, Delaware, and off to Ocean City, Maryland. All these ships come in for repair on the river. There are several repair yards where they do welding and painting. Not building of boats, but repair. See the variety, quite a few. Problem with the internet, I believe. Audio is coming in and out. Here's our osprey pair. That's live. That's them. It's a shame, though. They built that nest and chose not to have eggs. Here's a luxury cruiser. Look at that. Well, folks, I think we'll leave it with that. Have a wonderful, wonderful